Donald Trump says to protesters, go home. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. Donald Trump tells people to go home. Initially, Donald Trump said it was going to be a big event on January 6th. Of course, January 6th is the day where they actually officially certify and officially count the electoral votes. They officially certify a win and somebody becomes president-elect. Well, and of course, they're inaugurated on the 20th. Well, Donald Trump said, hey, we're going to have a big, big rally right here in D.C. on January 6th, and it's going to be huge. So yesterday, there was two elections. The election with two senatorial seats in Georgia, and the Democrats, they won both, which wasn't a big surprise to me because, one, the Republicans, Loeffler, and Perdue weren't particularly great candidates. They were traditional establishment candidates. And that's really what this is really all about. It's not just Republican versus Democrat, because you have Republicans working against Donald Trump as well. And not to mention the Secretary of State in Georgia. I'm not going to get into, actually, there's a situation where this guy, Brad, the Secretary of, the Attorney, Secretary of State in Georgia had a phone call with the president, and the president was basically questioning this guy's line of thinking and his data. It was really interesting. Look, it's establishment versus non-establishment, okay? The reason why so many people want Donald Trump gone is because he's not a part of the establishment. He's challenging the power structure in D.C. He's not beholden to China. And China has definitely influenced a great deal of politicians, a great deal of institutions within our country. The Chinese Communist Party. Well, anyway, the two Democrats won in Georgia, so there's going to be a 50-50 split in the United States Senate. Whoever becomes the vice president is going to be the tiebreaker, so it looks like the Democrats are going to take over. Still going to be difficult for Biden to really get much done, but anyway, today they had a hearing on the Electoral College, and some people objected. Saw Grassley, Senator Grassley, saw a little bit of VP Pence presiding, Vice President Mike Pence presiding over the whole thing. And I heard that Democrat from Minnesota talking about it. And to me, it's just one big show. I don't see them really doing anything significant. What they could do is say, hey, we can't certify these votes in Arizona, Georgia, or Pennsylvania, or Michigan, or Wisconsin. We're going to send this back to the state houses and have them do an audit and recertify. If they have to make a change, they'll make a change. That's what they could do. I don't see that happening. So anyway, they had their proceeding. It began, and some individuals, some protesters, and the media is calling them Trump supporters. They definitely had Trump gear on, but doesn't mean they were actually Trump supporters. I question everything the media reports. Anyway, these people rushed into the Capitol Hill. How is that even possible? The Capitol Hill? How are these people allowed to get that close? They actually ended up on the floor of the House, Capitol Hill. I mean, it doesn't seem, I don't see that. I don't believe this. There's something not right. Okay, so you mean to tell me there's a group of random people could just rush up in there in the middle of session? In the year 2021, with all the technology and security that we have, I'm a bit suspicious of that. Anyway, apparently one person was injured in a gunshot. They evacuated the senators. And so I don't know when they're going to resume this or whatever. The whole thing sort of seems sort of suspicious to me. And Trump is calling for peace. He's telling people to go home. He said he feels he understands that people are hurt. The election was stolen, blah, blah, this, blah, blah, that. What exactly was his plan when he actually called for all these people to show up? He had some rally earlier today. He was talking, but if you're there in D.C., if you can see this video, be very careful. Definitely have contingency plans. Have a way out of that place, because you never know when there might be some group that shows up pretending to be Trump supporters. They might do something crazy. Good luck, guys. Definitely. This country, some people are sending me some messages after the election last night talking about, oh, we lost the Senate. We're in trouble. First of all, there is no we here. These Republicans, they're a lot like the Democrats. Mitch McConnell was on the floor talking about how we how we have to respect the will of the American people. He's just completely ignoring all the evidence. It's not Republican versus Democrat. It's establishment versus non-establishment. Okay? These people don't give a damn about the American people. Anyway, guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.